Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Hate Plus. I'm so freaking excited to get back into this game. I had some other stuff I had to deal with, so I wanted to come in at, like, you know, right in the morning, but instead I had to wait until now, which is about 7 p.m. Oh god, it's been too long. But all day I was just thinking, yes, I get to go back into Hate Plus, I get to go back into Hate Plus, it's gonna be a new day. What's gonna happen? Okay. Let's go. Hyun-ae, good morning, although it's actually not morning for me, but I guess in the game world it is. After all that heavy stuff from yesterday, let's maybe take it a little slow before we get started. That sounds wonderful. That really does sound nice. Okay. Given the stuff we did yesterday with boring, stuffy ritual food, I was thinking maybe today we could do something more fun. What did you have in mind? Actually, that sounded kind of dirty. That's not what I meant. What I mean to say about that is I've heard rumblings that there on day three, which that is this day, there might be something that has to do with cakes. Let's see if that pans out. Yes, you can kill me for making that pun. Let's see if that pans out. We'll see. You know what I'm thinking? I think I might. Is it cake? I think it has to do with cake. Yes! Cake. Hyun-ae, I'm totally in. Okay, what are we gonna do? Before we go back to investigating, let's spend some time relaxing. Spend some relaxing time eating cake together, Mr. Investigator. That sounds wonderful. Wait, but you can't eat. I mean, you could look like you're eating, but you can't actually eat because you don't need to. Whatever, don't overthink it. The thing is, I don't really remember what it tastes like either. Yeah. Which is really sad, actually. It used to be my favorite thing to eat. I wonder if there's anyone who doesn't like cake. Okay, well, there has to be, but I mean, come on. Almost everyone likes cake. It's amazing. It's like pizza. In fact, the day before I was frozen, the last day I got to spend with my real family, my mother made chocolate cake for me. Did she? It was so good. The best in the world. That's my last memory of my original time, eating homemade chocolate cake with my mother. Aww. That's so sweet. But I can't remember what it tastes like at all. Isn't that awful? That is. Don't worry, we're gonna fix that though. Don't worry though, I've got a plan. We can just get you to bake one, and I can experience it vicariously through you. Perfect! I'm in. How does that sound? You'll do it for me, right? You'll actually go to your kitchen and bake a cake, so we can eat together? Hyun-ae, I would do anything for you. Yes, hell yes, I will make a cake. I promise I will. Not only will I kind of already have. Yeah, you'll see. I promise I will. So you'll do it then. Thank you so much. Right, well, there's two recipes I can give you. One is my mother's recipe. The other one that's so simple an otaku could do it in a microwave. Well, you might be impressed, because I actually know how to bake. I've heard of mug cakes that you can make by microwaving some, like, a couple ingredients in a mug. I've never actually made them, but oh no. I'm gonna make, and in fact have mostly made, the real deal. Or maybe you already have your own chocolate cake recipe? Well, let me go into more detail, then you can tell me which you'll do. Okay, my mother's takes 40 minutes to prepare with a cake pan in an oven, and requires the following ingredients for the cake. Okay. Here's the thing. The cake I've made, I don't actually have the stuff to make that. And the cake I've already made is not chocolate. I hope it'll do though, because it's the best cake I've ever made in my life. So it's not chocolate, but trust me, I think she'll like it. The simple one takes 5 minutes to prepare with a mug and a microwave and requires the following ingredients. Flour, sugar, cocoa, egg, milk, melted vanilla extract, chocolate. Ooh, I actually have the stuff for that. Okay, you know what? Just to make sure. Okay. If I'm sticking with this, and going exactly by what she says, and I'm going to meet her requirements of making a chocolate cake. I'm going to make the mug one. I'll make both, all right? I'll make my one, which is amazing, and then I'll make the mug chocolate cake, because I'm sure as hell not making another full cake. And I can't anyway, because I don't quite have the ingredients. But I can make this one. I have all of these ingredients. So, you should go down to your kitchen and check for ingredients. Oh, I already know what I have. I've got it. Do you have flour, milk, sugar, eggs, butter, vanilla, and cocoa? Yes, 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 and yes. That wasn't enough time to go check. Even if you think so, could you please double check? Don't worry, I already know. Trust me. Please actually get up from the computer and go look in the kitchen, please. What? Okay, Hyun-ae, I'll do anything for you. If you really, really want me to check, I will do it. Excuse me, I will be right back. Okay, I am back. Yes, I do have flour, milk, sugar, eggs, butter, vanilla, and cocoa. I'm assuming you're talking about unsweetened cocoa powder, and not like cocoa mix. I could probably make my own cocoa mix, though. Yeah, I'll be fine. Yes. Great, those are the most important ingredients. Good, good, good. Well, now that we know that, let's figure out what recipe you'll be using. Alright, which? Let's go with simple. Well, I mean, I kind of already made my own recipe, but it's not actually chocolate. So I'm gonna go with the simple, yeah. Very well, there's no shame in that. When I said any otaku could do it in a microwave, I was thinking of myself, really. I know you have everything else, but do you also have chocolate chips? Mm-hmm. Great. I have milk chocolate and I have semi-sweet, actually. I'll just pull up the recipe for you then, and you can just click on the button when you're done. Okay. Alright, let's look at the ingredients. And actually, I've never made a microwave cake before. This is going to be very interesting. Alright, so a bit of flour, a bit of sugar, a bit of cocoa. I don't know whether that's unsweetened cocoa powder or if that's supposed to be like hot chocolate mix. I'm not sure. Given that it's probably going to be unsweetened cocoa powder. One egg, a bit of butter, little, very small amount of vanilla extract, some chocolate chips, and some milk. Okay. Dry ingredients. Mix well. Mm-hmm. Alright, so basically mix everything. A microwave for 3 minutes. Wait until cake stops rising and sets. Then serve. Okay. Well, everyone, I will be right back when that's done. Okay, I may have gone a bit overboard with that cake, or rather, those cakes. But what the hell, it was fun. Anyway, I have returned with it. Here it is. It looks like a bomb kind of exploded in the mug. This is my first ever mug cake, but it looks pretty good. I hope it tastes good. Anyway, hello, Hyun-ae. Sorry, it's gonna be very shaky. I am. Let me switch hands. All done. All done. Mm-hmm. You bet. It's right here. I can't wait to try it. Very well. Please, be honest with me. Did you, the player, actually go bake a cake? Did I bake a cake? I baked two cakes. Well, actually, technically this mug cake wasn't baked, it was microwaved. But I microwaved one cake, and I actually baked the other, so yes. I bought one? Not really, and of course. I wonder how many people actually baked a cake. Okay, I freaking baked it. And by the way, if you're wondering, it's a very nice, it's a malt cake. It's got malt in the main part of it and malt in the frosting. It's really, really, really good. In fact, I will, I'll put the recipe for it in the description, actually, if you're interested. It is seriously the best cake I've ever made. It's amazing. Of course. Yay, that's so exciting. It is. Look at it. I can't wait to eat it. Oh my god, that's adorable, wouldn't it? Cake, cake, yes, cake. Oh, look at that. Eating cake together with the man I love. Oh, I know. Do you have a camera? If you do, you should take a picture of us together. Should I? Well, I've already kind of taken a picture. How would I do this? Make sure you get your cake in the shot, too. Okay, I will take another one. Cheese! Okay, picture has been taken. Alright, well, enough of that. Let's eat. Agreed. Mmm. So, how does it taste, Mr. Investigator? Well, let's find out. Hmm. It's actually... It's not as good as, you know, properly baked cake, of course, but... It's actually quite good. Hmm. It's surprisingly good. Hmm. Well, it's not burnt, no. It's moist, yeah. Ah, that's perfect. How lovely. Is it sweet? Your sweetness enough? Oh my god, that's so cheesy. I'm sorry, that's too cheesy for me. Okay, you know what the hell I'm gonna do it. Your sweetness enough. That's sort of a silly line, isn't it? Yes, it's very silly. Sorry, just sharing this moment with you has really gotten me into a funny mood. Hmm, lovely. I remember now. Oh, she's remembering! I remember the taste of a cake that was nice and moist, the kind that makes you just giggle with happiness. It's the best taste possible. Oh geez, that sounds a little bit dirty, doesn't it? Sorry. I honestly didn't even think of that until you mentioned it, but now that you do mention it, yeah, it did. Anyway. Thank you so much for humoring me. I know you put a lot of work into that, more than you usually would, so... I really appreciate it. You're the best. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's thanks to you that I can remember one of my happiest memories. No problem. I was happy to do it. It was fun. And ah, this is so lovely. I'm sure I'll remember this moment forever, too. Oh, I'm never gonna forget it. Thank you so much. I feel a lot better now. Me too. After everything, after all that stuff we were reading. Before, and now this? This is just nice. Ah, okay. Let me turn off this terrible light that I had on to provide lighting that went from horrible to slightly better but still bad. Let me just put that over there. Okay. Clearing the chaos from my desk, putting everything back, and we are good to go. Wait a minute, one more thing. What is it? Let me get in place here. Okay. One more thing. Hmm? So there's one thing before we get started. Mm-hmm. I realized that, you know how there were a lot of files that just looked like junk data? I did. Yes. Well, I think they're actually just encrypted with the same key that Mute's last note was. Ooh. As far as I can tell, it's a whole block of log files about Eun-a. Anyway, I'm nervous to read them, but I just thought you should know. I'm very curious now, yeah. Alright, well, no unread messages. 43% power, let's get to it. Sorry, Hyun-ae, I have to disable you. Be back in just a minute. Okay. So where, which ones are those? I guess they've been automatically switched over to readable now, I think? I think so. Oh, yep, yeah, yep, here we go. Oh, Eun-a, co-conspirator, M3. Alright, let's go for M3. Let's grab these, yeah. These are gonna be important. Very important. M3. Burned evidence, burned feelings. Whoa, this sounds like it's getting really dark. Any more M3? There's, wow. Yeah, there's a lot of M3. There is more M3 than I can take right now. Striking back at society's betrayal. So, Jesus, suicide note. Made interrogation from mute. I'm curious what that one is. Alright, yeah, let's just start on M3. Okay, these are not going to make for fun reading, I'm sure. No way. Respectful of family. Burned evidence, burned feelings. Queen consort. And maid interrogation. Alright, check the dates. 45, 43, 42, 42, 40, 38. Well, let's go with this. Eun-a, co-conspirator. Dear little sister, Mi-seun. Oh yeah, so that's, Eun-a, and that must be Mi-seun. Sorry about not coming home until late last night. I didn't realize you were already asleep by the time I got into bed. I'm sorry for disturbing you. I'm afraid it's going to be another late night, as the reception yesterday evening went much later than expected. And now I have to catch up on all the work I was going to do. It's the same old irrational nonsense from the Department of History I was telling you about before. I'm going to have to fire the department head, and there is so much paperwork involved. I even have to run it through my father, Counselor O, annoyingly. Is there a picture of him? No, no picture. Yep. The reception went wonderfully, though. Much better than I expected. You know how I feel about social events like these, like those, usually. I find them utterly pointless, and my obligatory attendance to be a waste of everyone's time. Politics are truly loathsome, and I really despise how overbearing they become lately. So I was at the reception, desperately trying to avoid being dragged into some tedious nonsense by my father, and instead focusing on chatting up a bookish gentleman who seemed to share my disdain for the whole thing. Wait, what? That wasn't what I was expecting from her. I was just thinking the same thing. She sounds like she actually has her head in the right place at this moment, but then later on she goes to do the whole death of mute thing that we read about from the death of mute note. Like, what the hell? This is not what I expected from her at all. Who seemed to share my disdain for the whole thing. I laughed at his unfunny jokes, nodded along a lot, let him think he was encouraging me to drink a little bit more than I'd like. You know, the usual. At first, I just thought it was a good chance to, no offense, finally get laid by a man for once, but then I found out who he was. And I think there's a lot more opportunity here. I was actually surprised to find out that he's Ryu Hyun-su, the Counselor of Captaincy. Oh, him. Yep. So that must be how they met. Yep, that is how they met. I didn't mention it sooner because everyone's got opinions, and I was worried that you'd be the type to needlessly bitch about politics even at a party, he said, very agreeably. You can't escape those people these days. I'm glad you're not one of them. Me? Oh, no. I think people get distracted by them too easily instead of focusing on the things that really matter, I said, summarizing my thesis about the myopic social destruction caused by the increasing discourse of democratization in a single line. She, sure uses a lot of big words. I don't get it. Yeah, hold on, let me read that again. Summarizing my thesis about the myopic social destruction caused by the increasing discourse of democratization, that's gotta be it. In a single line. Oh, okay. So, yeah, the short-sighted social destruction caused by the increasing discourse of democratization. Wow, so she's just staunchly against democracy, then. And what is it that matters to you? He tentatively tried to put his arm around my shoulder. And I shifted to let him while I thought about what to say in order to not intimidate him too much. The future, I finally decided on. Everyone's always about the now these days. Spoiler warning, the future sucked. Yes. Yeah. Spoiler, the future did suck. They certainly are. Always with the power mongering, always with the politicking. All everyone cares about now is scoring small points so they can take a step up. Nobody cares about stability, he told me what I already knew. Stability. That reminds me, actually. I've been trying to push more of the classics into the curriculum, you know, Confucius and stuff. I wish things were more like they were in those days, where knowing your place was the most important thing, you know? Jesus. Knowing your place. That is such a disturbing and disgusting phrase, isn't it? Knowing your place? Ugh. Just evokes horrible, disgusting things in my mind. Wow, I have to say, there's not a lot of women who would say something like that, he told me. It's unfortunately true. But that's really what I think is important. Like you said, stability. I worry about the future. I wish more people would. Yeah, right. If only. This is kind of boring. I guess, yeah, it is kind of boring. You can't tell anyone this, but I'm going to be announced as the new chief counselor soon, he said, as if there was anyone still left on the ship who hadn't had the rumor beaten over their head already. But all the council cares about is pandering to the crisis of the week, rather than caring about anything long-term. I hate being put into this position. It's something I'd been considering ever since he told me who he was, but I think there's a real opportunity to use him. I mean, not in a cynical, power-hungry, political sort of way, but I believe his discomfort at the current state of things could be leveraged to cause major social reform on a level that I can't do alone. I think we could change the Mugunghwa for the better. It would be radical, but he gives me optimism. Maybe this is a dumb question, I said, leadingly, but if you're going to be the head of state, why can't you just change things? Easier said than done, he said. I mean, I'd like to. I would love to see this endless political horror show of ours end for good. I truly love to. The ship deserves a lot better. There's only so much one man can do, though. Wait, she's saying... Yep. I guess this is where they formed their, plan or whatever you'd call it. What about one man and one woman? Is there anything I could do to help? I asked. There is, of course. Even then, on the spot, I could think of many things two conspiring parties in the education system and in the legislature could do to enact a radical overhaul of society. Slowly, of course. It would take many years at the least, but combined we have massive potential to shape the discourse and create circumstances that would make it clear what must happen to the Mugunghwa to ensure its future. What I needed to know is if he was really a man who had the determination to do that. I don't care about his ideas. Those aren't what's important. What's important is that he's man enough to want to, instead of just whining about it. I was worried he might not be. Maybe it's just the liquor speaking, I said soberly, but you seem like you're the kind of man who takes what he deserves. And what do I deserve? He asked, staring at me intensely. I stopped worrying at that moment. It was obvious where it would end, and he was good. Just knowing that he'd play the game with me after that conversation, I think it's a good sign. Well, you tell me, I said bashfully. Then he leaned in closer and stole a kiss from me. I quickly looked away, putting my hand over my face, pretending to blush. You're right, he said, removing my hand. I am that kind of man. I believed him. At that point, I slowly started to move away, making sure I looked bashful enough that he'd hesitate a little before letting me go. What is she even doing? This is so gross. Yeah, she is, she's one hell of a manipulator. She's a master manipulator. So, I should probably get going. It's getting kind of late, I said. He looked disappointed. It was perfect. When I first spoke to him, I thought I'd simply get laid. But if we are to have a lasting relationship, and I think that's in my best interests, because I think we have the potential to do so much more together, then I obviously can't just give that up right away. I want to apologize again. You can see why I was in a mood when I got home. I just realized something. I'll talk about it in a second, though. Maybe if you want, though, we could talk again about how I could help, I offered, hoping he'd name a date. He did. We're going to meet again to conspire after he's officially been declared chief counselor. But I'm feeling good. The night before last, I wasn't feeling optimistic about our chances of salvaging this awful hedonistic society we've constructed for ourselves. But given that I think with the chief counselor on my side, we can actually turn things around. I think it's only fair that I have to trade in my own bit of hedonism for that. Thanks for being so understanding and patient with me, little sister. As a result, I'm feeling more confident about the new school policies. And I'm not afraid to deal harshly with the Department of History dragging its heels. What irrational idiots. It might be way too much paperwork, but I'm still going to be glad to see heads roll. I'm looking forward to seeing more of that in the future. Mostly, I'm really happy to actually have cause to be optimistic about the future at all. I don't like her. No kidding! Neither do I. Anyway, that's why I'm going to be home late. Could you please have our maid send dinner down to the office? I'll try to be careful this time when I go to bed so that I don't wake you up. I promise. Thanks. I'd really appreciate it. With love, big sister, Eun-a. Okay, this is what I just realized reading this. Why is she telling her little sister all of this? I mean, this is like damning, incriminating stuff. She must trust her little sister so much if she's willing and wants to tell her this. I mean, look at this bomb she just unloaded on her. They must be really close. And I guess her little sister must share the same feelings? She must. Can we take a break for a minute? Sure. There's something I want to confess to you. Okay. Go ahead. If this is what your job is normally like, I think it's really great. I'm not being a burden on you, am I? You don't mind having me as a sidekick, right? I don't mind. That's, once again, another understatement. I freaking love having you as my awesome, beautiful, awesome, amazing, wonderful, awesome, yeah, I've said awesome like 5 times now, sidekick, hell yeah. I like, again, understatement, I like it, yeah. Ah, me too. It's really great. I just really like being able to do something together with you. It's just such a romantic thing, casually spending time with the person you love. And, hey, Mr. Investigator, I think you're really cool, traveling through space, solving mysteries. Yeah, this is pretty cool, isn't it? Now that I think about it. I can't wait until we get back to Earth, doing footwork, interrogating people, being out there in the world. I never would have dreamed, when I was stuck in the women's quarters of an aimless spaceship, that it'd end up like this. So that's why I want to continue to be your sidekick. I want you to be my sidekick too. Please be my sidekick forever. That would be amazing. When I keep reading about all these people from just 300 years before, when I was alive, it reminds me a lot of my original time. But it also makes me feel like I'm completely unprepared to get by in a society like that. And that's just a difference of 300 years. So I think I could learn a lot from being an investigator like you. From being your sidekick. Could you tell me more about the job you're going to be doing when we get to Earth? What am I going to be doing when I get back to Earth? Have I been told that? If I have, I don't even remember. Well, it's an excuse to go back to Earth. Ah, that'll be really nice, won't it? I want to see what it's like, to see flowers and seasons and weather and that sort of thing. I'm so excited. It's all so much more exciting than being a housewife. And a little bit romantic, too. Anyway, I guess I should probably stop distracting you from doing that job now. No problem. To figure out the whole story about what happened to the Mugunghwa in Year Zero. Let's continue to work hard together. Oh, there's another red message now. What is this? AI psychology. I don't like the sound of this. Dispatch control. I know you didn't ask or anything, but I talked to an AI psychologist to get some context for the whole robot girl shit show you've got going on. It's fine, I guess they know. It's fine that you're the whole stoic loner type and all, but it might be good for her to get some help. Anyway, I've attached what they said. I figured you'd appreciate it. No need to thank me. Dispatch control out. While meaningfully different on a lot of levels, AI construct psychology is generally modeled after human psychology, and I've personally found this is where the problems manifest the most. Often, the biggest issue in AI-human relationships has very little to do with any universal particulars of AI psychology, and more to do with very different perspectives on mortality. Interesting, I see where this might be going. Simply put, even now, human society is not really meant to accommodate immortality. Were an ordinary human to live for hundreds of years, they'd likely have a very similar experience. When you do a single thing for centuries, you eventually hit the limitations of differentiable skill. For example, a 500-year-old artist is more experienced than a 300-year-old artist, but the difference is so subtle it's drowned out by all the other factors to most people. At a certain point, too much experience actually becomes a detriment, becoming too overwhelming to parse and prioritize in most cases. Even given consistent processing power increases, as per Robertson's law, there's simply an upper bound in scalability when it comes to processing memories, and after centuries, this begins to take a toll. When it comes to processing memories, and after centuries, this begins to take a toll. What this translates to generally is a feeling of overwhelming despondency, although to much younger beings, AIs included, these sentiments can feel more akin to an old man shouting, "Get off my lawn." Yet it comes from a greater sense of ennui than that, a feeling of one's own mastery and knowledge of a subject being trivial compared to societal trends that become increasingly alienating. It often contributes to a feeling of helplessness. What was pioneered in 27th century psychology, then called robo-psychology, was the idea of re-specialization. For beings that exist in social spheres with humans, the best way to stave off those feelings is to consider the much larger scale, and instead focus one's energies on a whole new field, where learning new skills has a much larger personal impact than refining something one has already mastered. Does that mean we shouldn't investigate? Like, long term, it'd be a bad idea for her to be my sidekick? I mean, she did spend all of her time in here... it doesn't seem like she's felt like she's mastered any of this. I mean, she didn't even have access to the logs before year zero. I don't know. But she did have a lot of time to read just logs in general. But she doesn't seem to be feeling that. From what I can tell. For example, I personally used to work as a photographer until moving on to human psychology, then later AI psychology. I still take some pictures now, of course, and keep up with the work of people like Mark Lee, but I find it's much easier to be positive thinking and optimistic if I don't consider advancement of that medium to be important in my life anymore. I'm sure someday I'll feel the same way about psychology, finding new limitations and attitudes to be frustrated by. But it'll be comforting to know that I could help people while I was emotionally able to, no matter how cynical and slow I'll inevitably get. Generally, I find a good time to consider specialization, Jesus, having trouble with that word, is around the 400-year marker. Although obviously it depends on each individual. I don't know anything about your particular circumstances. It sounds like a culture shock is also a very significant factor, and that can change things a lot too. I would be very happy to speak with the construct in question at my private office on Earth, though. Consider it a personal favor for all you've done for me in the past. Dr. Autumn, the Susan Calvin Inst... Wait a minute, whoa. Dr. Autumn, the Susan Calvin Institute, North America. Wait a minute, Susan Calvin! Hold on. Like, a year ago or so, I read the Robot series of books. I think that's what it's called, the Robot series or something like that, from, Isaac Asimov, right? Yeah, Isaac Asimov. Susan Calvin, wasn't she a character in the Robot series, in some of the books? I'm pretty sure she was. I don't know if it's just Susan or Calvin or Susan Calvin, both. I don't remember, but I'm pretty sure that is. Nice reference. Well, that's... I mean, she seems fine, but that's worrying. Alright, what's left? I think I only read one. Yeah. Alright, 42, 42, 42, 40. Let's go with this. The most important thing. Oh, Mi-seun. Is that the little sister? Yeah. The relationship seems kind of unusual. It does. Oh is, so this is the little sister then, yep. Dear Mom, I don't have anyone to talk to right now. Normally, I just confide in Yana, but she is what I need to talk about. Our maid, Miss Huang. Oh, Yana and Mi-seun had their own maid. Well, just like everyone else in the game, she looks incredibly adorable. Well, okay, almost everyone else. Smith doesn't exactly look adorable. But most people are. Our maid, Miss Huang, told me, something I do that helps is to write a letter, but then never send it. And she said maybe that'll help. I sure hope so. Well, who better to address it to than you? Since I couldn't send it to you even if I wanted to. I don't think you ever would have had advice, but I don't know. I'll give it a shot anyway. It's just that lately, she's been so absorbed by this Chief Counselor Ryu stuff. It's all Ryu all the time. I know it sounds like I'm jealous, but it's not that at all. I mean, I'd never be jealous of her. That would just be being ungrateful. She doesn't owe me anything, I know. I'd never ask that. It's just obsessive. She doesn't even realize it. Lately, all she talks about is her plans to change the Mugunghwa with Ryu. She's really serious about it. It's all Ryu will overthrow the state, this, and will establish a new dynasty together, that, and I mean, she's big sister Yun-a. If anyone can do that, it's her. I just worry. What if there isn't room for me in her future? Yikes. Yeah, no kidding. Yeah. Her future was, not good, as we saw. You know the whole, that whole motherhood credit thing? No, of course you don't. You're dead. Oh, she's dead, okay. Well, it's a new tax thing where basically they pay you for being a mom. You'd probably like that. Anyway, she was telling me that pretty much she was responsible for introducing that as a bit of law. I mean, she's not on the council or anything, it came from someone else, but it was her idea. At first, I thought it sounded great, and I was really proud of her for managing to make that happen. Then she started talking about it, how the whole idea was to make more people get married, and okay, fine, I guess that sounds kind of romantic, right? But then she keeps going on and, like, she wants everyone to get married and have kids right away. She's saying that it's a moral imperative for girls to marry a man and have kids or else the ship will die off forever. I asked her, what about people who don't want to? That's awful, believe me, I'd know. Yes, yes you would. What if you don't want to be with some man? Sorry mom, I guess that's an explanation for another time. Not that it really matters or anything. Point is, I'd never want to be with anyone but Big Sister Yun-a. Everyone should, she said. There's nothing more important than reproduction. I don't agree with that. And I said that. I asked her, what about love and having a happy life? Like, you know, having an important job like she does? And finding love on your own means way, way more than hurrying up into marriage, right? You'd think that, I'm sure. Then she sighed and seemed annoyed and told me something like, and that sort of hedonistic and ultra-individualistic thinking is what has caused so much social ruin in the first place. I'm having trouble remembering her exact words. People worry about their selfish desires instead of worrying about their duties for the future. Wouldn't you agree that ensuring a functional future is more important? That's sort of the thing about her. It's impossible to disagree with her. I mean, she's really smart, way more than I am. There's a reason why she's university president and I'm just some girl. She always has a really elaborate reason for everything, and I'm sure she's always right. I just don't really understand a whole lot of what she says. I wish I was as smart as her so I could. I guess so, I said. Personally, I'll be happy when I'm out of the job and only have to worry about devoting myself to a husband. It'll mean that we've established a social order that privileges stability, and that things for the future will be fine, she said, and that really upset me. I don't like thinking about her getting married. Wow, I'll be happy when I'm out of the job and only have to worry about devoting myself to a husband. She wants that. Why the hell does she want that? What the fuck is wrong with her? What about love, though? I don't want to devote myself to a husband, I just want to be with the person I love the most. Don't you? What about other girls like me? I asked her, really anxiously. I don't get it, but I'm sure that's wrong. And then she said something like, but the ultimate Telos? I don't know what that is. Of love is reproduction. No, I didn't really understand either. So I asked her what she meant, and she said, it means that the most important expression of love is having children. Anything else is socially dysfunctional. There's lesser forms of love, of course, but being with a man's the most important. It has to be. I think love is more important, too. Me too! The most important expression of love is having children. Bullshit. Complete and utter bullshit. You think we have a lesser form of love, big sister? I asked her. I was crying a little. Sorry, Mom. Even as a grown adult, I'm still a crybaby. She sighed, then hugged me, and, well, it didn't make me feel better. Then she said, I'm sorry, little sister. I still love you very much. I never said you didn't matter to me. You'll always be close to me. That's why we're sisters, right? I only meant that there's things more important. I didn't mean to dismiss your feelings. Well, you did, I said, and then I stormed off to go sleep on the couch instead. I couldn't. I've never been good with fights with her, especially since, well, you know, she's smarter than me, and uses words like telos, or talos, whatever that is, and is going to take over the ship. I'm not stupid enough to think that I can argue with her ideas. She obviously really is always right. I mean, that's why she's big sister. It's just... She's really cruel, I think. Well, she says things like, I didn't mean to dismiss your feelings, but then she says something that does dismiss them anyway. She's the most important thing to me. I don't know. It's fine if she doesn't feel the same way about me, but I wish she'd at least acknowledge that. Okay, you know what? Forget it. The maid was wrong. This isn't helping at all. It's just making me even more upset to think about it. This is stupid. I'm going to stop now. Wow. So, yeah, it sounds like, I was thinking that, Mi-seun felt the same way that her sister, her big sister did, because of what Eun-a said to her in that note, in the diary. But apparently she doesn't feel the same way at all. Unfortunately, she seems to lack this, the confidence to believe in her own opinions, or, you know, commit to them. She just seems to always defer to her older sister, which is, well, given who her older sister is probably not going to end well. All right, what's next? 42, 42, 43, 45, okay. These are both on the same day. Whoa, this is 2 years after the last one. Burned evidence, burned feelings. Whoa. Well, that's gonna get interesting. Let's go for this one first, though. Respectful of family. Ex-counselor O. Consort. And I thought her name was O. To Pyeon Mi-seun. Yep, that's a little sister. No photo. I've tried appealing directly to O Eun-a. That's her, yeah. But I've been rudely ignored. I'm hoping, as her consort, you'll at least be able to see reason. Wait, consort, and I thought her name was O. Wait, what? Wait a minute, and I... And I thought her name was... Yeah, wait, what? Pyeon Mi-seun. O Eun-a. Wait, they're sisters. Are they... If they don't have the same name, how are they sisters? I mean, I just assume... Okay. I'm sure you already know, but I lost my position as Counselor of Education because of the absurd meritocracy exam. Do you have any idea how much of a humiliation that is for our family? Not even the Counselor of Education, the one who's supposed to be responsible for the exams himself, could get top marks? We could have even lost our noble status. Did she even think of that? It's one thing to show disrespect for family and not care about the loss of face, but what the hell is even the point of having an O as the university president if she's not going to do anything to safeguard our family's status? She promised me that voting for meritocracy wouldn't have any impact, because she could influence the exams, yet here we are. This does sound like a bad situation. Yep. You need to convince her to make this right. As for the road she's going down right now, what if next time is not even a distant O that gets chosen as Counselor of Education? She could lose her job, and that would be disastrous for both of you. I'm sure there's some sort of irregularity in the exam results. If she can't be convinced to put this right, I implore you, you have to find evidence that the exam results were mishandled, for your own sake. Do you really want the woman you're counting on to be so reckless about her family? Do you really think you'll be able to keep up your comfortable lifestyle if her family continues to decline? I'm counting on you to do the right thing. Oh, Chung-woo. No, yep, no photo. Wait, what is this down here? Dear Mr. Oh, you got my name wrong. Wait, what? I'm sure she did what she thought was right and honest, and I don't think telling someone to go behind her big sister's back is very respectful of the family. Sorry. I guess she's really loyal to her big sister. Yeah, she's super loyal, but you got my name wrong. What? Something's going on here. I seriously doubt he would just get her name wrong randomly. That's weird. Pyeon. Hmm. Alright, well let's figure out what the hell is going on here. Burned evidence, burned feelings. Oh, Mi-seun. Wait, writing on paper? I thought that was illegal. Wait, illegal? Why would that be illegal? Dear big sister. Oops, oh crap, I didn't mean to close that. I miss you. Don't worry. I did get your letter and I did what you told me. I found those papers with the counselor of candidates on them. With the counselor of candidates on them. Wait. If she thought that was illegal, then why were they written on paper? It was kind of hard to find. Those Chinese characters that you wrote didn't really look the same as the handwriting. Anyway, I set fire to them, just like you asked. Even with all the Chinese I can't understand, I think I figured out what they were about, and I get why you didn't want those records in the computer. I was really shocked by how easily paper burned, though. For all that, it's so expensive and forbidden, it's so fragile. Anyway, I got all that done, so don't you worry, big sister. But I really wish you were here to do it yourself, just because, well, I miss you. I know. You've been spending time with Ryu lately because it's important to you. If you like him and like doing all this work, then I'm glad for you. I just wish you were here. When I got out the candles to destroy the evidence, it just made me think of when we used to have dinners together by candlelight, and how perfect things were then. Oh, that's really sad. That is. A little sister that looks up to her big sister, and defers to her in everything, and can be very easily manipulated to do pretty much anything by her big sister. That's such a vulnerable kind of position to be in. And unfortunately, her big sister is such a terrible person that it just, well, I guess like I said before, it's not going to end well for Oh Mi-seun. Yeah. I don't want to be demanding or anything. You do what's important, and I'll help you out however I can, and that's good enough for me. I'm thankful you're around at all. I just worry a bit about you because you used to get really fired up all the time about sociology stuff, but now, well, you don't. And I'm off burning evidence that you rigged the counselor exams to pick people that Ryu likes. Since when did you care so much about politics? That's right! She was never interested in politics. I guess she changed her tune when she wanted to change society. Well, I guess Eun-a wasn't always like that. Yeah. Well, since there's no way I can send this letter to you now anyway, I might as well keep going. I'm sorry about that fight we had last week. You were right. I really was just being hysterical, and the cramps weren't helping any. But we've lived together for how many years now? Feelings always run a little bit high when it's that time of month for both of us. I'm sorry for starting all those arguments. What time of month does she mean by that one? I'm sorry for starting all those arguments. And there's no excuse for getting into pointless dumb fights with you. I just, well, it was just a lot of feelings of insecurity adding to the usual bitchiness. I really worry about you, and I don't mean to alienate you like that. Hey, do you remember when I got dressed up and showed up at your office to say hi at the start of last month, and you shooed me out because you were worried I might have a whatever the heck you said, whatever influence on Ryu when he came to visit. That really hurt. I ended up locking myself in the bathroom to hide from the maid while I cried, and I just wanted to do something nice for you. And then when you got home and got into bed super late again, you acted like nothing happened. I really wanted... I missed... Where was I? I really wanted to say something. I still do. It's things like that that make me feel insecure. God, I feel so bad for Mi-seun. She's so sensitive. And it's the most important person in her life is Eun-a, who's a horrible person. And she's so sensitive. She's just gonna be destroyed by Eun-a. Oh no. What am I to you? You used to be so protective of me and gentle, and you'd always tell me how you were feeling. What changed? Are you at least confiding in Ryu? No, of course not. I know, like you said, no man is going to find emotional insecurity attractive. And all that stuff, about how it'll lower your sexual value in his eyes. So I guess you're keeping it all pent in now and keeping it to yourself. I wish you wouldn't do that. You can still confide in me. I can still be here for you, big sister, if you just let me. She's lucky to have someone who worries about her so much. She is. It sounds like Eun-a doesn't appreciate Mi-seun at all. I'm okay with a little bit of crying. That's normal. I'm a little bit too sensitive at times, but I can deal with it. But I can't stand to see you get so distant. You need someone to talk to you. You can't just keep everything to yourself. That's not healthy. Please, take care of yourself. Don't just hide in this obsession of yours. Please, 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 please. I'm begging you, big sister. Just... I don't even know what. Be in my life. Please. Ugh. I guess there's no point to writing any longer. I can't really send any of this to you anyway. It'll just make things worse. Here's my real letter, then, I guess, and I'll copy it into a new file to send to you and keep this one just to myself. Dear big sister, I lit the candles just like you asked me to. Don't worry, it's all dealt with. Hope I see you soon. Love, Mi-seun. Oh. God, that's the message she got. Man. This is just sad. Once again, we are delving deeper into tragedy. Okay, two more. Let's go with this one first. Queen Consort, Eun-a. That way? Dear little sister, Mi-seun. Sorry about not coming home at all last... Wait a minute. Have I read this before? No, I haven't. Okay. Sorry about not coming home at all last night. I spent the night with Ryu. It wasn't in that way, though. It's just that we stayed up so late talking. I think it's the most time we've ever spent together, on reflection. Lately, I have felt a mixture of anxious and tired. It's not as though I'm not optimistic. I know what the future has in store, and I know everything will work out in the end. I've dealt with that professor that was giving me hell. And things are back properly on track, but the initial excitement of finding Ryu has worn off, and at the same time, the end is nowhere in sight. I wish things weren't so damned complicated. I can't sleep with him now, despite yearning for it. After all, men are wired to desire things differently than we are, and would probably throw me away soon after. And as much as I want to get laid, it's even more important that I ensure my status in the future. By which I, of course, mean marrying him. Of course, divorce still exists, so if I want to be truly safe, I'd have to have his kid. I think we're still a long ways off from being able to politically justify banning divorce, although it's naturally an end goal. Oh, great. However, I can't marry him now because it would draw too much attention. So I am stuck as his secret, his private girl, and that makes me feel, well... It doesn't matter how I feel, really. It's worth it, in the end. I feel really uncomfortable reading this. Me too. It's a natural end goal to get rid of divorce. And it doesn't matter how I feel. It's worth it in the end. I wonder if she can actually hold up through this. Can she... She seems, I don't know, devious? Is that the right word? She seems... committed enough to see this one through? But it sounds like she's cut herself off from any real form of intimacy with anyone. Which can't be good. So, yeah, we'll see what that does. We talked about it, at least. That's all that happened. No work, no conspiring, no grand political machinations, or however you pronounce that, machine, I don't know, whatever, being designed or brought into practice. Just a brief glimpse of what the future could have in store, if we could bring it to life. I sat on his lap, and he held me, and stroked my hair. And for a brief moment, I felt as though I could actually let go. That none of the other bullshit on the ship, that none of my other responsibilities, that nothing at all that I needed to concern myself with existed. Save for him. In that moment, my mind raced, thinking about that. Thinking about how perfect it would be if that was our future. Rather, if that was our ship's future. Wishing to an extraordinary extent that this perfection could not only be saved forever, but shared. She thinks of it as sharing. Forcing this on other people, she thinks of it as sharing. What is wrong with her? That is not sharing. What are you thinking about? He asked.
Just you, I said, touching his chest and smiling up at him.
I love you. I don't ever want to leave your side. That's awfully precious, he said. You can be really sweet at times, for such a scheming mastermind. I don't want to be that, though, I said with a pout, but meaning it utterly sincerely. I just want to be yours. Poor girl, he said, then kissed me repeatedly until it got to the point where it was getting intense, and his hands were starting to roam places. I wanted him badly, little sister, let me tell you. But I'm only telling you this so that you know how hard it was to stop him and ensure it didn't go any further. I can't, not before, I trailed off, letting him fill in the blank. Marriage. It wouldn't be right. I'm not just some modern whore. That sounds like something my mother would say. He murmured in agreement, seeming pleased enough, but then to my surprise, I finally got the best response I could have hoped for. I don't remember his exact words, being far too engrossed in the moment, but he promised he would marry me when it was possible. If I'm going to lead the ship back in traditional ways, I'll have to set an example, won't I? He said. Of course, anyone who really studied history properly would know that even the greatest kings and emperors had as many consorts as they wished. But I didn't say anything of that, nor did it even come to mind at the time. Nor do I still think it's important now, particularly. Being an emperor's consort really isn't as romantic as she thinks. You mean, I'll get to be your queen? I asked, with excitement in my voice. And it honestly wasn't acting, or me picking my words carefully, or any other form of insincerity. Well, it can't be now. It would seem suspicious, and I don't have enough power for it to not matter. You have to understand, he said, and of course I did, seeing as I was the one who had suggested that to him in the first place. But you will, I promise. A promise isn't enough to ensure my safety. I cannot give in to what I always wanted from him those years ago. I can't run the risk of him throwing me away if he no longer thinks of me as pure and virgin. And if our plans for the future do work out, I'll need to be his queen to ensure my status. Why? When I put that all into words, it's such a cold way of thinking of things, though. In that moment, all I was thinking about was him. I don't want the weight of running a university on my shoulders. I don't want to have to work to save the ship from the immorality and unsustainability of modern society. I don't want to have to dedicate myself to a vicious world of politics and professionalism. All I want to do is spend my nights dedicating myself to just that one man. I don't want to have to worry about anything, save for being a good woman. I don't want to have to worry about scrutiny from suspicious meddlers, or anyone else's opinions of me, save for his. I don't want to have to assure both you as well as myself that the future is worth being optimistic about. I just want to be there. I had a glimpse of that future last night. He promised me that he would make me more than just his lover. Better than a co-conspirator, he actually committed to making me his queen, little sister. I want that future to be now. Then everything will be perfect forever. I'll be the consort of the man who's ensured that the Mugunghwa's decline will be rectified, and my reward will be a life full of knights as perfect as the last, instead of them being so frustratingly rare. She's wrong, it didn't solve anything. It just made things worse. Yeah, it didn't solve anything.
Sorry I didn't come home last night. I'm sure you understand. With love, Big Sister. Alright, one more. Maid interrogation by Mute. 45. Well, that's pretty recent. A transcript fragment of a conversation held with the private maid of Eun-a's household. That would be... Oh, whoops. Yep, that's her. I guess... Counselor Mute, my lady. I'm kinda glad someone's asking about my mistress. I haven't talked to anyone about this before. You know, it just wouldn't be right and all. That. But I've really been kinda worried about her. She's been kinda... I don't know. Unstable? Interjection from Hyo So Young. Unstable how? Has her routine been different recently? Okay, so this... So she's talking to Mute and Hyo So Young. Nah, I guess unstable is the wrong word then. More like unhinged. She keeps the same schedule and all, working late. Well, just between us, most of the time she spends working is actually spent off with Chief Counselor Ryu. They've had a running affair for years now. Don't tell her I told you this, alright? She made me swear to keep it a secret. I wouldn't be telling you if not for, well, you know. But yeah, unhinged. In a really weird way, like I'm not wearing this bland dress because I want to, it's because she dressed me up like this. Yeah, that's a thing she does. No, not in that way. In a totally innocent way, just, it's weird. Like, when I first worked for her, she was really insistent that I wear... I guess the idea was, like, traditional clothing? It was supposed to be more modest or something, to fit the style she likes. Funny how she never complained about her little sister dressing immodestly, just me. Well, whatever. Anyway, this is supposed to be morning attire, and there was this huge long lecture about how it's the traditional and, proper, I guess, thing to do when someone close to you dies. Wait, who close to her died? Oh, morning attire, of course. And you know, Mi-seun, her little sister, was my mistress, too. Wait, hold on. Wait, the suicide note, was that Mi-seun? Oh, fuck. And you know, Mi-seun, her little sister, was my mistress, too. And she was the one who spent all day at home. So I knew her pretty well, so I figure it's fair enough. Oh, fuck, Hold on, I need to know. 45, Mi-seun, hold on. Suicide note. Suicide. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Look at the dates. She killed herself. Oh, God. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to get that in the next block, because I really want... Well, I really want to read it, and I really don't. At the same time, just... Interjection from Hyo So Young. How is she unhinged, then? Oh, well, it's... Really, it's been ever since her little sister passed. It's been so quiet around the house without her. Well, as for my mistress... I don't know. She's just been kinda, well, she had a really weird relationship with her little sister. It's not my business, you know. I didn't want to pry. I just made sure that their bed was kept nice and tidy each morning, minded my own business, and sent the salary I get paid to mind my own business back home to my own family. Honestly. I was getting to that part. What's unhinged is just, it's like the other day, she wanted me to make tea for her. No, making tea is not the unhinged part. I'm getting to it. After I poured it for her, she just suddenly insisted that I have some myself. Which I always do anyway, but not like, together with her, which is what she wanted this time. Yeah, I don't remember anyone drinking tea with the servants either. Hmm. That's weird, right? Oh, I guess artificial women don't drink tea. What do you think, though? Hyo So Young interjects to confirm, it is weird. See? I thought it was weird. But I'm not really going to argue, she's my mistress, so I pour for myself. Then she gets me to sit down right next to her. I was practically on her lap, at which point she just tells me about her day. I thought it was leading somewhere to some sort of point, but no. She just went on about what she'd done and what meetings she'd been in and how she felt about them and all that. I didn't know what the hell to make of it, Then she got to, and I realized I'd forgotten to bring the lunch little sister made for me, so I had to. And so on. That's a little bit, wait, what? I'd forgotten to bring the lunch little sister made for me, so I had to... Yeah, she's not dealing with it well. She has no one to talk to. That's why she's talking to the maid. Just no one to talk to. As much as she seems cold in many ways, she's still... There's some, you know, humanity in her. At which point, she started to cry. There was a good whole minute of sitting there uncomfortably, you know. What the heck do you do in that context? Thankfully, then she excused me and I got out of there as fast as I could. I don't know what she did after that. Yes, cried a lot, probably. That's just one example. Another time, she wanted me to warm up her bed for her because she was staying out late. I don't know. She's. I don't ask questions like that. I don't know. I just... No, I didn't do that. My point is just... she's been really unhinged since her little sister passed. That's all. I don't really know how to feel about her anymore. Yeah, it... I don't know what to make of her. She had horrible ideas to begin with, no doubt about that, even when she had a good relationship with her sister. She was still planning on killing democracy, and she still had a dream of a society where women are basically forced to marry and have kids and so on and so on. So it's not as if that stuff only came later. However, she seems to be, well, as they called it, more unhinged. As time went on, especially after her sister. I still hate her, but... Yeah. I don't know what else to say. I still hate her, but I'm also just sad. A little bit for her, but mostly for her sister. Her young sister, that killed herself. I'm really not looking forward to reading that note. It's probably going to destroy me. Okay, I think that's it for... Yeah, alright, let's extract some more. Let me save it just in case. Alright, we need to grab that one. Oh wait, did I just re-enable her? Whoops.